Hello friends, welcome back to Achu's Royal Kitchen. Today I am going to make a Christmas special traditional fruit cake, an eggless and alcohol-free fruit cake. So let us see how to prepare this cake. First we have to soak the dry fruits which we are using in this cake. I am going to soak these dry fruits for 4 to 5 hours. For soaking, I have taken 2 tablespoons of each of the dry fruits, chopped cashews, chopped almonds, tutti frutti, white raisins, chopped dates, chopped black raisins and plum, half cup of fresh orange juice and half cup of sugar. We are going to soak these dry fruits in orange juice and caramel syrup. First, we will prepare the caramel syrup for soaking the dry fruits. For that, we have to caramelize the sugar. I'm adding half cup of sugar to a pan. Keep the flame low. The sugar has started caramelizing. So while caramelizing, make sure that flame is always low, otherwise the sugar will get burned fast. Sugar is caramelized. Now we will add 1/4 cup of boiled water to this. After adding water, the caramelized sugar will crystallize. Stir it continuously, it will get dissolved. Now our caramel syrup is ready. Switch off the flame and allow it to cool down. Next, we are going to soak the dry fruits. For that, I am going to transfer all the dry fruits to a big bowl. Cashews and almonds, either we can soak with this, or if you want to maintain the crunchiness, you can keep it separately and add at the time of making the cake batter. If there is any seeds in the raisins, we have to remove it before adding to this. The detailed list of ingredients and quantities I have shared in the description box below. So please check description box for more details. Now we will mix all the dry fruits together. Now I will add orange juice to this. Here I have taken half cup of fresh orange juice. Now we will add the caramel syrup which we have prepared. Actually, the purpose of adding caramel syrup is to give a nice color and flavor to the cake. Normally, Christmas cakes are having a rich dark color. So, by adding caramel syrup, it gives a nice color to the cake. Orange juice and caramel syrup should be sufficient to soak these dry fruits. If you feel it less, you can add more orange juice to this. Now our dry fruits are ready for soaking. We will cover this with a cling wrap. We will soak it for 4 to 5 hours. Almost 5 hours over, we will check the dry fruits which we have kept for soaking. We can keep the dry fruits for soaking in refrigerator also. We can refrigerate it for 1 week. It is soaked very well. Dry fruits are now swollen and it has absorbed the liquids which we have added. It looks really nice and colorful. Next, we will prepare the cake batter. Let us see what are the ingredients for preparing cake batter. I have taken 2 cups of all-purpose flour, 1/2 cup of powdered sugar. Here I am using dark brown sugar. It gives more color to the cake. Total, we are using 1 cup of sugar in this recipe. Half quantity I have caramelized and half quantity powdered. 1 tablespoon of cocoa powder to enhance the color of the cake, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon cinnamon powder, 1/4 teaspoon nutmeg powder, 1/2 teaspoon dry ginger powder, 2 teaspoons of vinegar, 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 1/2 cup of vegetable oil, 1 cup of milk at room temperature, dry fruits which we have kept after soaking, and a pinch of salt. For mixing the cake batter, we will take a big bowl. To this, I am adding milk, 1 cup of milk which is at room temperature. Now we will add 1/2 cup of oil. You can use any oil which is flavorless. Mix it well. Now we will add powdered sugar to this. 1/2 cup of powdered sugar. Here I am using dark brown sugar. This also enhances the color of the cake. In this recipe, we are using 1 cup of sugar. 1/2 cup we have caramelized and 1/2 cup we are adding at this stage. Whisk it well. Now to this add 2 teaspoons of vinegar. Combine all the wet ingredients. Now we will sieve the dry ingredients into the wet mix. 2 cups of all-purpose flour or maida. 1 tablespoon of cocoa powder. This also enhances the color of the cake. 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon powder. 1/2 teaspoon of dry ginger powder. 1/4 teaspoon nutmeg powder, 1/2 teaspoon baking soda, 1 teaspoon baking powder, and a pinch of salt. Now sieve it well to the wet mix. Gently mix the dry and wet ingredients together. While mixing the cake batter, always mix it gently, preferably by cut and fold method. We will mix this to a smooth batter. I am adding few drops of vanilla extract to this batter. Now we will add the soaked dry fruits to this, along with the caramel syrup and orange juice. Now gently fold this together. Batter is almost ready. This batter will be sufficient for making 2 cakes of almost 1/2 kg each. Today we will bake 2 cakes, one in oven and one in cooker. Now we will bake the cake. I am going to bake this in a paper mold. You can grease this with some butter. Place this on a tray or anything like that for some additional support. Fill batter up to the half of the mold. Gently tap this to release the air bubbles. Now we will add some dry fruits on the top of the cake. I am using chopped cashews, black raisins and chopped cherries. It's ready to bake. Preheat a cooker. Remove the rubber gasket and whistle. Now we'll place the cake batter inside. I have kept one tray inside the cooker. Bake this on medium low flame for around 30 to 40 minutes. We will bake this cake in an oven. Preheat an oven and bake at 180 degree for 30 to 40 minutes. Baking time may vary depending on your oven settings and temperature. For me, it took around 40 minutes. We can insert a toothpick and check whether the cake is cooked from inside. If the toothpick is coming clean, then it is cooked. Otherwise, if still batter is there, we need to cook it for some more time. Both the cakes are baked perfectly. It's very soft. We will open the paper mold and see how it looks from inside. This is the one which we baked in oven. The cake has got a perfect color too, like that of a bakery style Christmas cake. See the inside texture of the cake. It is very soft and moist. Hope you all like this video. This Christmas, do try this recipe at your home and share your comments in the comment section below. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and relatives. I will be back with another new recipe. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.